Hello everybody! Welcome back to my third episode of Bonsai Geek series. I'm Jan Kulek and today I'm going to show you the wiring and styling process of a Scots pine out of bonsai nursery stock. If you haven't seen yet the part number 1 and 2 of the series, please watch it and you will get the entire process from the beginning to the end.
I apply the first structure wire in these two branches. So two of the main structural branches are on its position and I'm gonna continue in the same style with the rest of the branches and I'm gonna build up this entire main structure of the tree. So I continue with the wiring process with all of these main branches and notice here how the upper portion of the tree starts to be visually separated from the rest of the tree and this main line of the trunk. So I'm gonna put a very thick wire here and manipulate with this entire section here and then I'm gonna continue with this main structure branches. So I put the aluminum wire of 7 millimeters diameter here in this section. I continue with the bending process of this upper part and as you can see it's quite intensive work and because of that it's very important to have the tree really well attached to the pot. Here is the result of the main structural work. Looks a little bit like an octopus, right? But that's not a problem, because the focus of the work was here, inside of the structure of the tree. Each of these branches has a strong character and movement now. And now I'm gonna work with the secondary branches to put them into the photosynthetically efficient positions. And the shape of the tree almost magically appears. So the work is almost done. Just the apex left, so I'm gonna wire up a few of these branches and put them into the right positions. Okay, so the work is done. I laid down the main branches and then in the next step I lay down the secondary branches and put them into the horizontal position to make them really efficient. And the very last step, which I can do, is to clean the bottom lines of these branches. It is not super important to do it right now. I'm not obsessed with the shape and the design of the tree because the main focus of the work was to create a main structure. I'm going to clean all of the needles which are hanging down, like here for example, very simply like that, carefully to not damage the tissue of each of these shoes. So the step number 1 was the repotting of this tree out of the big plastic container into the ceramic bonsai pot. I reduced the size of the root system and because of that I left all the branches on the tree. And the branches, the abundance of the needle mass helped to recover the root system faster and develop new root system faster. Then during the late summer 2019 I laid down the main structure of the tree. I put the general movement into each of these branches and I set the secondary branches into the more or less horizontal horizontal position to make them really photosynthetically efficient. I removed few of the branches which can cause the structural issues and future swelling of some parts on the tree, but in general I try to keep a lot of branches. When you work with the pines out of bonsai nursery, very often you need to deal with quite long and sparse branches. And every tree is a little bit different. Sometimes you will be able to use most of the branches, some of the trees will need some bigger reduction. Every tree is a little bit different. But in general, try to keep as many branches as possible, even the unnecessary branches, but these unnecessary branches are your helpers. Take your advantage from these branches, because these branches holds the additional needle mass, and more needle mass will speed up the process. You really build up the strength and the energy of your pine, so the tree will be much more vigorous, and vigorous and strong pine starts to produce new buds and build the big budding faster and much more steady. And once the big buds will be strong and long enough, first you receive the buds, then very small branches, and gradually these branches start to elongate. Then you can start to remove the unnecessary branches which are too long, or they are located in not ideal positions. So it's a process, it's a gradual step-by-step process. It's like a loop. Strong roots means strong growth, and strong growth means even stronger roots, and this starts to build up the new buds in your pine. I hope this information would be helpful to you guys for your own experiments with Scots pines, and thanks to all of my followers, subscribers and viewers of my super dry, geeky bonsai video series. And leave me a comment or write me an email. I would love to know your opinions and your experiences with Scots pines. Hope to see you soon in some other episode, and